What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Third Person. This is the Third Person Podcast. My name is Chris, and with me, as always, are my buddies Jesse and Mike.
How's it go?
What's up?
Everybody, welcome to our third Walking Dead Q&A. We asked you guys for questions, and you guys, once again, did not fail us. You guys gave us a bunch of questions, and so we're going to answer some of those questions. And I just want to point out very quickly, if we didn't get your question on this video, we will most likely answer them in the comments. So we're still going to answer your question, yes. But we can't answer all in the video because it'd be a two-hour-long video, and that could be kind of boring. But so if you didn't make it in this video, we apologize, but we will most likely get to you in the comments or wherever you put it. Wherever you post that question. So, without further ado, again, thank you very much for all these questions. We're gonna roll in order here. We've put them together.
And possible comic spoilers ahead.
That's right. There's definitely gonna be possible. Definitely possible.
Spoiler alert.
All right. And we won't tell you when it happens. So be on the lookout. Keep your ears pricked. All right, Mikey. Why don't you start us off with our first question?
Our first question of our Q&A 3 is from John Blaze, one of our regulars on YouTube. John says, "Hey guys, I'm glad to see Negan get a taste of defeat in the finale." Me too. "How long do you all think All Out War will last in season 8?
That's a good question.
That is a good question. I'm assuming that it's going to be the half season. You know, by the end of the season, I think that we can get a lot of action that way. You know what I mean? If we drag All Out War for a full season, I'm sure you guys agree, it may be too much. I mean, how many battles or so? I'm really thinking that they're gonna push this and they're gonna get this into an action packed half. You know, 8 episodes.
Yeah, I'm gonna agree with that. I think again, this was one half of my theory. Already, you know, for what this season was going to be, but I think it's going to go to the break. I think they're gonna finish that arc to the break, and then you know whatever comes afterwards, because like you said, we've already done the build up. We just had this whole season of a build up. Mm-hmm. There's nothing else to build up. We've got the characters in place. You got Morgan. You have Carol back. You know, Daryl's ready to go. Dwight. So we'll have a little development with Dwight. And don't forget. They all came together right at the end, so they're there. They all know they're ready to go.
Jess.
So you bring up an interesting point with Dwight. There, we haven't got Dwight helping Eugene yet,
right?
So that's at least 2 episodes worth. Then 2? We also have that's 2 episodes worth.
Okay.
Then we have a couple of battles that are at least an episode apiece. All right.
If they're gonna go that route, I don't think they're gonna do that for TV.
We don't know yet.
I know, but
and then there's a lot of pre-planning. So earliest we'll definitely see the end of All Out War mid-season. Latest, we're definitely going to probably
get a full season.
There's a lot of diplomatic crap going on. There's a lot of fighting. Yeah. There's a lot of other stuff. Yeah. So.
Yeah. I hope not. I hope it's action packed.
At worst. Full season, best half season.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, Sean. Why don't we move to the next question from Christy T. She asks, "Do you think the show will incorporate the time jump after All Out War?" Now, this is the other half of my theory was that if you guys remember this, we're gonna get the end of the war at mid season, and then when we come back mid season, we're gonna get the time jump. I still hold fast to that. I think that's a strong possibility.
Well, let's for non-comic readers, if they don't want to hear about the time jump, maybe you guys can kind of let us know a little bit what happens with a time jump for the people that don't necessarily know where that comes from.
Oh, so, wait, you want to explain what happens?
Well, how long it is and stuff like that.
Okay.
2 years, right?
It's 2 years, yeah.
2 years time jump, you see the development of Alexandria, how it's become a giant town. You see Hilltop expanding, Maggie in lead, she has a baby. Then you see the kingdom not being fully run by Ezekiel, but still somewhat run by Ezekiel. And Michonne's on a boat. There's the time skip. And
Michonne becomes a pirate, yeah. But the main thing is they've basically...
It's a 2-year jump.
Rick has created this very large community with these smaller communities. They held up Alexandria, the kingdom, and even Sanctuary is a part of that. And they're all working together. There's trade routes and stuff like that. So they've built this entire, you know, this really cool thing. So that's where the time jump's gonna go. Yeah. And then you know, obviously there's another new thing which will, you know, enemy which we'll get to. Mike, what do you think? You think they're gonna incorporate that or not?
I'm debating it because, you know, I'm not as super as far as you guys with the reading of the comics.
Yeah.
So I don't necessarily have a real large opinion of that yet.
Yeah.
I think that we've mentioned this quite a bit, how the show is incorporating the big elements of the comic book. Sometimes they change characters that are dealing that something major happens, but they might have changed the character or something like that. Or they tend to use the big plot points, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, they stick to big plot points and they mold it around their own story, right?
Exactly. So since this is a big comic book plot
point,
then I'm assuming they'll go along with it, you know?
All right.
But who knows? The show could be totally different. Yeah. You know what I mean? The show can go a total different way.
Yeah, definitely could.
Mm-hmm. But I think the different way they're going to go, All That War ends mid-season, and then we don't get a time jump. We actually go straight into Rick's recovery, Alexandria's recovery, Hilltop, all the recovery, plus a little bit of development for future, you know, time skip stuff. And then end of the season, it cuts at a very happy scene or something like that. And then we get a time jump going into season 9.
So you're saying season 9 is where we get the time jump. Yeah. That's definitely a possibility. I do think that second half of season 8 would be boring as hell, though. Without
I don't think it would be too boring because they do have walkers to contend with again.
Yeah, but that's not a major threat anymore, unless it's in a giant.
So you're saying it would be super boring to have some kind of prosperous, positive for the good guys.
Listen, God, really, you think 8 episodes of them being like, hey Rick, how are you? I'm okay. Great. Hey,
it wouldn't be like that. It would be like Rick out there after being beaten, battered, and broken. And he's out there, he's fighting walkers and stuff like that, and he's struggling to do so because he has a bum leg now.
Yeah, but okay, we'll but again, like. 1-2 episodes tops. All right,
then we got Carl. We also have Maggie.
And you know, they do love to separate and do like 1 or 2 characters at a time.
Yeah, exactly. That's why
I'm still saying it'd be boring. I'm still saying it'd be boring. I'm sorry. It'd be boring.
It's the most...
They're going to lose. If you have momentum where you finished All Out War... mid-season, you have that momentum and you go into that, they're gonna lose viewers, man.
The beginning of the time skip's kind of boring to some people, so
but that's either quick way, though that would be that'll be like a one
they can sum that up in like 1 or 2 episodes,
yeah, you know, like what's one and been, one and a oh half God, episodes,
yeah,
you know?
In these 2 years, whatever.
Yeah,
hey, we got 7 months or so to wait and see, you know?
So why don't we just move to the next question, because we could debate that all the time. Jesse, what's the next one we got?
All right, from KidSlap13, another regular. Do you think TV Negan will have redemption? As you all know in the comic, Negan changed. Or do you feel the show may not go that route and kill him at All Out War?
I like this question.
After All Out War,
yeah.
This kind of goes with the fact how I just said we never know what story they'll take from the comics, right? So now I'm more of a proponent because I just hate seeing Rick beaten and broken, like Jesse said. I wouldn't mind seeing Negan getting axed after season 8 or have the half season after the All Out War instead of the way the comic book route goes. But, you know, I guess we'll see. I personally, if I really want to, you know, tell the truth, I think we're going to see Negan for a while.
I'm gonna agree with seeing Negan because the thing with Negan is the aftermath of, and especially after the time jump and stuff like that, it's real interesting. Like that, I won't spoil it for that. I guess we won't talk about specifically what happens with them there, but he doesn't die, and he remains there. And now in the comic, like getting to him where he is now, as a quote unquote free man or a free agent and not the leader of the Saviors. True. Like, that is some real, real interesting stuff. And there has been some stellar scenes between Jeffrey Dean Morgan and Andrew Lincoln. That's been some of the best stuff that they filmed.
I would love to see the comic like that. Yeah,
you know what
Do
I'm
you
saying?
Think
like
that, it would be difficult for them to portray Negan as. Do you think that they can redeem him on the show?
Yeah, listen, the one thing, you know, can I tell you something? Two things. Mm. Jeffrey Dean Morgan, I think, is really popular. I think his character, his Negan, is really popular this season. And I think that's why people are staying on, because he's got that Supernatural behind him, the show Supernatural. He's got that behind him. He was the comedian in Watchmen. Like, he's got all those things, and people know him from those things, right? I bet you it brought people in because they were like, oh, shit, this guy's going to be on here. I like this guy. But not only that. I also feel like one of the reasons why they got him to be Negan, because physically he doesn't match the stature of the guy in the comic, right?
Yeah.
But he's so good at being endearing. And I think that that's what they want. Like, they want him to pull out those guns and be like, look at this character that you can completely look at, even just the small portions of him talking to Sasha. Like, we were all like, oh shit, Negan was nice. Oh damn. Like, that was,
that's true.
Some potent shit. So I think that, yes, I think he's going to stick around. I think they're going to use him at the end. Will they, and will there be that? Well, based on what's going on in the comic, there isn't real redemption involved in that just yet. But I mean, you know, well, I think we're definitely going to see him. I think they're going to go that route, or they're going to do their version of it, because he is a slightly different Negan.
Yeah.
As far as redemption goes, he hasn't even gotten in the comic yet. So
exactly. Yeah.
Redemption will not happen as soon as people are hoping it would.
Right.
But like you were saying, Negan is a complex character. We get him in the comic. He's dropping F-bombs left and right, but in the show, they can't use, you know, F-bombs left and right. So Negan's a sarcastic douchebag that has a little bit of a sick, twisted humor inside of him. And you gotta love him for it, because of the way Jeffrey Dean Morgan portrays him. Yeah. Kind of is not as broken as you can read into the comic Negan. Comic Negan, you don't have the dialogue or the affliction in his voice or anything like that. It's just you're reading the words and you're saying, yeah, he's probably a sarcastic douchebag.
Right.
But redemption wise, I think he'll be redeemed. Maybe we don't even know in the comics. So I'm saying, like, maybe four issues from now he gets redeemed, and maybe that's when it happens in the show.
I don't even think he's getting redeemed in the comic, to be honest with you. I don't think he is.
Based on a few of the covers, no, I don't think he is.
I don't believe in the comic right now. I don't believe that. I'm not 100% sold on Negan's position right now in the comic. I don't trust that motherfucker as far as I can throw him. So, anyway, all right, cool. That good.
Yes.
That's a good.
All right. That was a good one. That was a good question.
Thank you, kid. Appreciate that.
Yes, sir. Our next question is from Crimson Riddle. He's gave us, I think, questions from both Q&As that we've had
absolutely.
So far. So that's cool to see him chime in again. And I also like this question. Do you think we will see a Negan flashback?
I love this question.
Well, then you started off, Chris.
I love this question. The answer is yes. The answer is yes, because of mostly what I just said about Jeffrey Dean Morgan, is that he's too good. He's too good to not have him show Negan's backstory. Not only that, if you guys don't know, we did a Negan's backstory video, so you can go check that out. Negan's backstory was released in comic form in the monthly
Image Plus,
the monthly Image Plus magazine, and they had a 2-3 pages worth of comic, giving Negan's backstory, you know, from the beginning of the apocalypse to when, you know, whatever, until when he first met up with, you know, maybe beginning of his saviors and stuff. Yeah. So I absolutely think that we will see it. I think because it's great TV. That's just great. That's great.
Of course.
Plus, we know that they love doing flashbacks.
Yeah. We see them to even the minor characters, like with Enid and.
Yeah. So I absolutely think that we're going to get that. And I think it'd be actually really interesting, because they can promote the shit out of that.
Oh, hell yeah. I mean, my thing is for this is, Now, just like you said, we saw you know, a handful of pages of comic about Negan from the very, very beginning. Will they show that part of it? Will they show the whole Lucille part of it? Or will they give us maybe a bit further, or you know, where he took power in the sanctuary?
Yeah, I mean,
you know what I mean? Will they start? Where will they start?
I think they'll start relatively at the same spot, right? I mean,
you know what I mean?
I think, right? What do you think, Jess? Because I think it, I think that's a good place to start. And yeah, I think they will go up to the point where he gets into power.
So, if you haven't read the Image Plus comics yet, this is a major spoiler. Because I don't think we had the last couple of issues when we did our video on it.
Right.
But we get to see him and Dwight meet. Dwight is leading this group of people. And in the 12th issue, I believe, is when Negan takes charge and starts leading them. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty awesome. And if they don't do a Negan flashback, I'm going to be sorely disappointed.
Yeah. I think we'll get that in season 9. No, eight.
I mean, they get give Fear the Walking Dead stupid little 10-minute or 5-minute clip or whatever during the commercials. Yeah. Give us a Negan clip during the commercials like that. I would love that.
Oh, that would be interesting. Right? Yeah, that'd be something to watch. Yeah.
There you go, AMC. Right. Take that idea.
Yeah, there you go. Cool. All right. Cool. Well, I think that one's a. I think we've gotten all we can out of that for now. Right. Yep. Cool. All right. Next question from one of our other regulars, Lisa Jett. She says, do you think we'll ever find out what Negan's bandage is from? So, Jesse,
I want to hear you guys' opinion on this, because I know what it's from.
Well, all right, so
wait, can I ask you a really dumb question? Which bandage is this
on his left hand?
On his hand. He has the band-aid always.
He has his hand covered up to his wrist right here.
Yeah okay. He always had that?
He's always had that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess. Hey, I don't know. Is it a comic thing? I'm assuming, right?
Jesse? No.
Yeah, it's in the comic, and I believe it's also in the show.
Oh, fuck. All right,
so I just don't remember.
Yeah, Jesse.
All right, so neither of you know.
No, I totally
it's a baseball thing. He's a coach. It's a baseball thing. It's to support your wrist there. They also do it in MMA.
Oh, but that because.
It gives your wrist a little bit of support. That's that on his. Swinging the bat, he doesn't break his wrist.
Okay. So he doesn't have a wound.
No, it's not a wound. It's literally just a support.
It's just so he's wrapping. It's like a boxer. When you spar, when you work out, you wrap your wrist up.
Also, if like you're doing kendo or something like that, you have a giant, heavy wooden bamboo sword.
Yeah, it will shot
your
wrist. Yeah.
That way you can. Yeah,
that makes sense. Hey, not for nothing. It could have been his wrist could have been slightly injured or something when he was, you know, from back in the day. That could also help it.
Yeah, when we so got the backstory of him being a coach, I figured that's what it was. I was like, yes.
Yeah, you know what? And going back to the previous question, that's definitely going to come out, or at least it'll be implied, and you just extrapolate it like you did. So yeah, great. Okay, yeah. So, but will we ever find out what happened on the show? You know, maybe. Like I said, if we do the flashbacks, it'll be implied. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool.
So we have a similar question here from both Bobby A and Elisa Jett. Do you think we'll see Sherry again in season 8? And Bobby adds on, if so, what role will she play?
Well,
I love my Sherry.
You do love that Sherry. Sherry baby.
Okay. Yeah. Hey, she's out there. They didn't end her role. She's like the Heath where they just disappear. Yeah. You know what I mean? So
Heath went to 24. We already know that.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's true. He went to a different show and different world, but
Sherry went to 25. No.
Sherry, I think they set her character up for us to see her again.
Yeah.
I can see her. Let's not try to get into too much with where she is in the comic. If people don't know about that, or if you guys want to mention it a little bit, we'll just, you know, say.
Well, let's just say,
You know, Sherry, I don't believe she will follow the comic path necessarily. I would like to see her, and I mentioned this in our Sherry Eugene video, that I wouldn't mind seeing her take on like an Alexandrian kind of, just come with Dwight if Dwight changes over. Let her have that relationship with Dwight as a good guy. You know?
That could be.
No?
I don't see it happening, no? though.
Well, maybe not necessarily within the first few episodes, because obviously we still know where Dwight is. But Dwight is playing both sides of the fence right now. So will we see her soon? Will we see her later on in the season? Who knows? But I like the sweet, nice come together.
I know they don't do that often in this show. When they do, enjoy it. Yeah,
not always.
I'll tell you man. So I can see her helping out. I don't know how you feel, Jess, but two options: either she's going to come back and take on a similar role that she does in the comic, or we're going to, or Dwight will find her out in the wilderness dead. That's what I think.
So I don't think Dwight will find her out in the wilderness dead. I don't think that's an option. I think what will happen is she will show up at the hilltop shortly before the final battle.
Okay, to what end?
What do you mean, to what end?
Why? Why is she going to the hilltop before the battle?
I don't know. She probably knows that the hilltop exists, so she's going to go there to seek shelter.
We know you live in Atlanta, Jesse. Now, do you have, the inside scoop or something that we don't know, or is this just...
just speculation.
watch her just pop up in the hilltop, and we're all going to, look at Jesse.
What we don't know is that Jesse's got the drones out right now, and he's scouting.
Totally. Over there on my second monitor, actually, right over there.
Yeah. All right, cool.
We'll see her again. We'll see her again.
Very specific ideas is what I have about this show and where it goes.
All right. Let's thank you guys. Let's move to the next one.
Yes, Jess. That is my turn, correct? We're going with John P. Do you think Jadis and Rick will team up and eventually kill Negan together?
No.
Yeah, I would probably have to agree with that. So. I mean,
do you think Rick will? Let me put this to you guys. Do you think Rick will team up with Rick and rip her fucking spine out? I think that might happen.
Didn't we see at the end? I mean, when we saw Negan speaking with everybody, all his saviors, and saying it's party time. You know, we're going to war, guys. There weren't any. No scavengers there.
They left. They all fucking bolted.
They
grabbed the guns and they bolted.
All right, well, a good question is, to add even to this, is who's Rick going to go after first if he goes?
Well, I mean, here's a funny thing. That's a good question, because now not only we don't just have Negan now. Now we have this Jadis. So guess what? I just thought of something. We keep saying they might do this break in the middle. I don't know now, because
the
I'm thinking...
The first part's the war against Jadis.
They might pull out two or three friggin' episodes of him going after Jadis, and... Oh, God. Wow. But, and not only that, don't forget, we just learned... What do we just learn about Jadis, about the actress playing Jadis?
She's now a series regular.
She's not going to be a series regular, at least for season 8. So guess what? She's a part of that.
Oh, but that doesn't necessarily mean she's going to be throughout the whole series and season. I mean,
didn't they promote Bob to a series regular in season 5 and then kill him?
Yeah, listen, we saw Carl for one or two episodes this season. You know what I mean? So it depends on, just because they say she's there for season 8, she could be in season 8, episode 1 or 2, and then get killed or something. Yeah. And that technically she's in season 8. You know what I mean? So maybe let's not play so much into that. Yeah. But I guess
how about this? To legit answer the question,
it's not
completely unfathomable to think that at some point Rick and Jadis make nice, and they attempt to go after Negan. If she's a series regular now, there's going to be something with her, right? Will they kill Negan? No, they're not. Negan's not going to die. They're not going to kill Negan. They're not going to kill Negan off.
You know what? Think about, too. Now, when we saw the deal before Shiva comes bouncing out and everybody's saving the day, we saw Jadis and Negan's little deal for the people.
Right.
Now, obviously, they didn't get to finish that deal because of what happened.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm sure we'll probably see that in season 8. Maybe Jadis and the scavengers saying to Negan, hey, you know what I mean? Some kind of confrontation about getting the people that
Mike,
and maybe that'll cause a rift.
Well, listen, since you're talking about it anyway, let's move to the next question, because it's kind of what you're saying from Elisa Jess. Yeah. She says, what do you think Jadis wants with the 10 people from Negan? I think maybe it could be a pretty dark and maybe turn them into Winslows. okay. Which it was the, you know, that dude with all the spikes coming out of him and stuff. This could make them possible whisperers. What do you guys think? So that's a rumor that the garbage pail assholes turn into the whisperers, and that Jadis is possibly Alpha from the comic. And if you don't know what that is, spoilers.
I don't think so.
No.
I kind of like that idea, but
totally separate.
But listen, what I think is, as far as these people, my initial thoughts about that were, she just wants to replenish her stock. Like, she sees people as objects the same way as food or weapons. You know, like, she made a deal with Rick to get guns. She made a deal with Negan for that. But here's what pisses me off about that, and I had said this when we were watching the finale and all the videos we did on it. But fuck that. Why? How? Negan's gonna allow that they get out from under Negan's fucking thing?
We'll learn. You know, maybe it's something we'll learn. Maybe he did have some kind of. I don't necessarily think that is the case, and I agree with you. Like, how did they escape Negan's clutches? Maybe until it's now kind of bullshit, they never knew of the scavengers. You know, until Jadis came to Negan and said,
yeah,
Rick is coming after you, and he kind of gave them a break because she gave Negan some vital information.
Yeah.
Which I'm assuming that's probably the case. Now, the 10 people thing for me, this room is floating around all out there that they could be cannibals. Like
I said, during the discussion, I think, for the finale.
Yeah, I've heard this on other, you know, other Walking Dead type of channels too. I don't believe it's a cannibal thing. I think I agree with Chris with we need them for workers, we need them for fighters, and
right, yeah.
I think the scavengers are loners. Obviously, I think they would rather be by themselves and protect themselves and be happy alone together. You know what I mean? And they want those bodies, obviously, for in case there are people that want to take, you know, so they have the strength in numbers. But it's going to be a conflict in season 8 when we do see Jadis and Negan talking about the 10 people.
So it's going to be a sticking point. Yeah, it's going to be.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't think she's just going to say, all right.
They never got that. Yeah, they never got. Yeah, I don't see her letting that go. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. As far as whether it was, yeah, probably workers or something like that. But whispers, if AMC introduces whispers this early on, right, if they think about doing it, they have ruined any chance for the big reveal in the from the comic, because the way they go with revealing the whispers is perfect and saying, hey, Jadis and them are whispers. You might as well put a gun to the show's head and kill it now, because is not going to fly.
I agree, too. That's such a big part of the comic book for them, for us to already meet them. You know what I
don't
mean?
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen.
I don't think that. Supposedly, I don't know if you guys seen these other videos, but supposedly there's an actor, an actress that was casted as a possible Alpha.
Really?
Yeah. Forgive me for not knowing the name. I've seen some, you know, I've seen
I think
some.
That's just like hearsay bullshit.
Yeah, hey, I mean, you never know, but hey.
Then again, that's what we're doing, so yeah. All right, cool. Why don't we move on to the next question?
Alrighty, so from Frank Fox, Eugene made 2 pills. Well, we see Sasha had 1. Who's next? Yeah,
I have no idea.
Who is next?
I have no idea, because that's a
maybe himself.
It's a device that we haven't seen.
I'll go with himself.
Ah. So, taking a hint from the comic here, Eugene is locked up in a cell somewhere. Maybe he has said pill on him, and he slips it to the guard of his cell. Or has Dwight slip it to the guard of his cell, and they escape.
Wait, where is Eugene? Eugene's in a cell right now?
No, in the comic he was, remember?
Oh my god, yes. That's right. Wow, yeah. Okay, like, maybe, yeah. Or, alternatively, nothing. It's a lost...
Yeah, nothing.
It's just one of those lost things. No one remembers that there was 2 pills and it was lost.
I think it was there for a reason, because I think when we first
I think we got the reason, and Sasha used it, and that's it.
But they specifically held the bag, and there was two when you know what I mean? Hey, it could be nothing. Maybe Simon gets it. Maybe Eugene tries to get Negan, and the plan foils, and he doesn't get a chance to pass the pill on.
Okay, so you think it's going to show up again? You think it'll definitely show up again?
I think it could. I think it could, because I remember we were all questioning where it was going to go, where the first pill was going to go.
Yeah, true. True. Okay. You know what I mean? All right. Okay. I guess there really isn't anything else to, pontificate with that. It's either we're going to see it again and it's going to be used, or we're going to see it again and it'll be foiled, or we're going to see it again and it won't get used. Or we don't see it.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right. Our next question is from Alyssa Jett. Who do you think will kill Simon?
Oh, man. See, now, the thing is, Steven Ogg, he is another tertiary character that just got signed on as a series regular, at least for season 8. But doesn't mean he won't get killed. I think he will get killed. I think it'll happen during the war. And I think it's going to be one of our main characters. I would love to see either Daryl or Rick kill him. That's who I...
Yeah. I mean, I agree with you that we're going to need to see some big savior deaths. You know what I mean? I think we can see multiple. I think we can see Jadis killed if they get involved somehow. I think we can definitely see Simon and maybe even poor little Shiva. And I think we're going to see a lot more of that this season. It would be cool to possibly see Jesus get in there. Maybe it would even be cool to see
Jesus will kill him.
Gabriel or something having a major kill, or Rosita, or, I think it's
Tara,
up in the air.
Yeah.
It's all speculation to me. Perhaps Michelle? We see Dwight do it.
That's what I was going to say. Dwight is going to be our man to kill Steven Ogg. You're going to have someone kill Ogg, it's got to be someone that's going to really put an exclamation mark on it. They're fighting against Rick and them, and then all of a sudden, Dwight turns around, pops Steven Ogg, and then goes on fighting for Rick and them. What I think is going to happen.
Okay, yeah.
Boom. Boom.
But he's going to die. We all agree he's going to die. Yeah. Okay.
D-E-D.
Cool. All right.
Unless he becomes John from the comics.
I don't know who John is.
One-eyed John.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know what? Maybe he might stick around. Shit. Damn it.
One-eyed Willy.
No, I think he's going to die. I think they're going to make
him. Yeah, I think he's dead. Yeah. We only have enough room for one-eyed person, and that's Carl Grimes.
That's Coral. Let's move forward, guys. We're almost done here. Bear with us, guys. We're almost done. We're almost getting three questions. Next one from James A. With the possible time jump approaching... How do you think AMC and Kirkman will keep the show from catching the comic? Now, I had some thoughts about this previously, and I think that it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. And the reason I say that is because I've listened to multiple interviews with Kirkman, and he's like, he doesn't even, like, he's like, the stuff that's happening in the show now, he's like, I don't even remember writing it. He's like, I know I wrote it. He's like, but I don't remember. He goes, and they'll come to me and ask me, what were my thoughts and what were my feelings and what did I want to, to be the outcome? And he's like, I don't remember that shit.
That was a fucking long time ago, right?
Yeah, because he's written that shit years ago.
Yeah.
Will they postpone that? Yeah. We're going to finish out what's going on, in the comic now. By the time they get to where they are now in the comic, the comic will have already been another arc in, do they really care about catching up? I really don't think they do, because like Kirkman probably says, he goes, they can do what they want. This is their thing. He's not even writing on the show right now. I don't think he's really written on the show in a while. So he doesn't really give a shit. He's busy with Outcast anyway. And the comic version of Walking Dead. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
sure. I mean, let's see how long this kind of goes with how one of our first questions, how long do we think All Out War will last?
Yeah.
Will they stretch it so they don't let the comic end? You know what I mean? Will they, that's probably a good, now thinking about it, that's probably an answer to a lot of that, that maybe they will stretch out All Out War for the full season, because how much more can he write? Kirkman can be writing, how many more issues by the time that whole full season is completed. So I don't think that they're going to do a Game of Thrones catching up kind of a thing. You know what I mean? Like where you are in Game of Thrones and where George R. Martin is with the books. Yeah. You know what I mean? I don't think that we'll see a catch up. I think that there'll be too many, because listen, we all know Kirkman's still writing these, and he's said that he can write 300 issues. You know what I mean? So yeah, for me, I don't think we'll see
a catch up.
No, I don't think we'll see a catch up. I think that they can prolong it enough to get more out of the book before that even ever happens on the show.
Yeah, one thing I did not consider when I was talking about the time jump earlier is that we could very well get the end of All Out War, stretch it out until season 9, and then after season 9, we don't get a time jump at all. We actually get hunting down the scavengers. That goes until the mid-season. Then we get more development of Alexandria and them, and then season 10 starts to become a time jump. That's also another, possible thing they could do. And I honestly wouldn't mind a full season of them going off and hunting down these like straggling saviors and all of them, like a half of a season, 8 full episodes of nothing but that.
Yeah.
That would be pretty good.
I don't know, man.
They might not even incorporate the time jump. We can get no time jump. They can kill Negan after this season.
That's true.
You know what I mean? We they can do so
many villains can be like spawned out of nowhere during the off season. It doesn't matter. Yeah.
I mean, it depends. It really depends. They can go so many different ways.
The only problem I have with that, with all of that, is where they are. The villain. All right, the problems that they were having in the current comic is so unique and so different. And besides walkers, who else can you have? We've had cannibals. We've had asshole, small gangs. We've had, Negan and the governor. And, there isn't...
We've had the wolves.
That's what I'm saying. Like, we've had so many, it's human or walker. Like what, we've had herds. We've had large herds, and we're not done with those either. Like they're going to show huge herds.
I'm going to be excited with that if that does happen, because I do know of that there's spoilers, thousands eventually that are coming.
Yeah.
So we're not done with that. But the thing is,
I miss aliens. That. Don't you guys miss that?
Yeah.
Don't you miss the fucking threat of walkers?
Yeah, yes, but they have to be the living dead. That if I get scratched or cut or bit, I'm turning into.
Well, except Rick, that motherfucker apparently is immune because they don't even go to bite him. They just kind of push him around. Her too.
You smell bad.
They just push them around. But anyway, that's whatever.
Andrew,
so I don't know. I just feel. I don't want it to be boring. Like, come on. Like, don't.
I think they're getting a little bit of heat. Don't you think that they're feeling a little bit of that heat after these last couple seasons? I'm sure they hear what people are saying.
That puts us into our next question, actually.
And the next question is,
someone who has to be known as D.
What up, D?
Do you think AMC will increase the budget after this season due to the heavy usage of CGI coming up, or will they decrease it due to the viewer and rating drops?
the CGI part of it, I think they're going to save a lot of money, because unfortunately I think that she was going to be killed relatively soon.
Yeah.
We did see that they put a lot of money into that with that fucking deer at the carnival.
The deer keeps coming back.
And don't forget the back and when the safe, the garbage, scavengers.
The junkyard. Yeah.
Some shit man.
Let's see. Like Jesse said, and like I just said, with feeling the heat, I definitely feel 1,000% that AMC understands that people are getting outraged. I mean, the show number one gets astronomical numbers. Fear the Walking Dead, which it's a good show. It's a decent show. You know, I may be a little biased because of how much I love this genre, genre, and I love Walking Dead. But even that show gets crazy fucking ratings that they don't may not necessarily deserve. Because I know people that fucking hate that fucking show.
Yeah.
And I know a lot of diehard people that watched Walking Dead that just fucking quit it.
On average, just hearing like just the people around my job, you know, say, oh, this, that, and some of my other friends, that was kind of this, that was kind of that. And it's like, shit, man, people did not fucking like it. Yeah. But we all know where it goes and what happens. So we're all just like sticking in there. And like, we didn't like, I mean, look at some of our ratings. Like, some of our ratings are like,
twos and 2.5s.
Yeah, we had some shit episodes.
We did, because that's what we're saying, you know? We're saying, let's not get in 16 episodes, you know, the premiere, the mid-premiere, mid-finale.
If you're going to do that, you know, like, those don't, are the best. Yeah, like,
because I fucking don't want filler.
But they have to, because that's how many they've ordered and whatever. But the point is...
Well, get creative and write something. But about the budget,
yeah.
Yeah, so the budget, look, I mean, honestly, you guys realize that every Walker kill, and pretty much every Walker kill is a CGI kill, right?
Yes.
They have the fake, fake knives, they have the heads being chopped. Like, they are putting still a lot of money into that. That tiger and the deer, like, those are things that were basically out of budget, in my opinion. Like, those were just, like, things that they don't normally do. I don't think the budget's going anywhere. I think it's going to stay the same.
I can agree with that.
And it's going to be, it's got to be
an expensive little salary. Yeah,
and all the prosthetics and all they got to pay for all the extras and like the clothing. And like, I get it. Like, that shit, you can buy like 1,000 garments of whatever at a thrift store. That, you know, that's not the point. But I think the budget is going to stay where it is. And some of the CGI is going to be phenomenal, and some of it's going to suck shit.
But why?
Well, so we haven't had a budget decrease in like 5 seasons. I think we had one going between season 1 and season 2, or it might have been season 2 and season 3, I forget which. But we haven't had a budget decrease since then. We've had an increase since then, and then it stayed the same ever since. However, I think we are due for an increase due to the price of inflation and all that, and CGI is getting a little bit more expensive still.
Well, how about the fact that the fucking show gets 15 million to 20 million viewers
every fucking This one lousy, like, part of a season, not even a full season, like, maybe 5 to 6 episodes were horrible and got horrible ratings.
Yeah.
But I don't see them cutting the budget due to that.
This is not the time to be cheap.
No, I don't think.
Especially not with what's coming
up. Plus, listen, AMC has... It's one of my fucking favorite channels. If not my favorite on cable TV. Yeah. Because, you know... And I don't even have cable TV anymore. You know what I'm saying? I'm a Netflix Hulu fucking guy, you know? So,
an emulator guy.
You know? Yeah, so it's like... They have between all... Think of all these shows. Guys, they have so many shows that I'm sure are fucking killing it. Yeah. Just killing it. This company is raking in the cash. I'm sure there's a lot of overhead. I'm sure they've got a lot of shit.
We do a lot of AMC stuff. We sure do.
And you know what? Well, fuck it, man. We're AMC fanboys because they do some of the best shit on TV, and that's bottom line. Bottom line. Bar none.
Wasn't Walking Dead turned down by HBO?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Imagine how fucking crazy.
And HBO, Walking and that's another. I subscribe to HBO too, because HBO's got some phenomenal stuff. Obviously, Game of Thrones and Leftovers and stuff. But you know, but again, like yeah, like I mean, I don't think they've got HBO money, but they're getting there, man. I haven't looked at any numbers, you know, but they for a cable television station, like you know, like
they're killing it.
They're killing it.
I want to point out that. We recorded live, is what we did. We recorded it live, and we used the AMC live stream to do our live recording. We had the hardest time ever getting that thing to work for the season finale. If anybody thinks that the ratings dropped on that season finale, you are dead wrong, because it takes a lot to take that player down.
That server, that server was so full we couldn't even watch it. We couldn't even watch it live. Yeah. It was so ganked. It was ridiculous, man. It was like, so yeah, no, that was definitely, you know, a big thing for them. But anyway, so
I think we've tackled that question, and I have a surprise question here that you guys have not seen yet. You've not heard, it's from me.
Oh,
we didn't get a grenade this season, correct?
Right. Your patented grenade. Yeah.
So how do you think AMC and The Walking Dead will handle having two babies on this show? We're going to have a baby Judith and eventually a baby Ree.
Do you think? I'm still at the point where I feel like Maggie's going to lose it.
That's what I was about to say, because Judith now is too old. She has developed features that I don't think they can get away with killing off a child that young.
I don't think Judith is going anywhere. I mean, let's see if they do incorporate the time jump, if they do bring in a bit older actress to play Judith in the future. But I think, wouldn't it add to Maggie's fucking rage to lose the man that she loved?
Of Glenn, yeah.
You know, her father. Maggie's just been fucking bombarded with death from her sister.
She's the only one left of her family, man.
I would like some good for Maggie, so it wouldn't kill me if she did have the baby, but I think it would just add to her fucking tough skin, you know what I mean? To just her badassery.
All right, so what I think that's crazy, because I agree with Mike that it'll add to the fire of Maggie and you know, which could
There's
be fun.
A fire
could be right.
Burning in my heart.
it could spell real she's trouble for Gregory Adele, though. You know? Oh yeah, she's just Adele doesn't exist though, man. She shows
Not
up.
Yet,
they have a cameo.
Some big woman just shows
doesn't
up.
Doesn't Knife Party exist? Therefore, Adele should.
No,
she wasn't popular then. Yeah,
you blocked me on Facebook, and now you're going to die. Was a song that stupid shot itself and got Glenn underneath the dumpster plate in his van.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that was the song from like 2013.
All right, well, look, I don't know about whatever. I don't know if Adele's in Walking Dead or not yet, but the point is, well, let's look at it this way. If you're going to compare it to the comic, you know, where we're at in the comic, her, you know, she has a son and he's 2 years old now.
One and a half, she has two.
So, right? One, two. Yeah, so, and then don't forget, Sophia is still alive,
and
that's her daughter. So we figured that's going to. So Judith isn't alive in the comic. Where does Judith fit in now? I can see if they want to continue that same dynamic, which isn't a real big thing in the comic anyway. No. You know what I'm saying? But you're right. If they don't want to have more than one kid, yeah, they can kill off the baby. Sounds so horrible to say, and then keep Judith as the kid, because she's there now and it's
Listen,
a thing.
Yeah, she was in the hilltop, so maybe maybe it's not like Rick is the one that's babysitting, you know what I mean? Maybe
stay and have my friend's daughter.
Maybe it's Enid looking over them, Maggie looking over, maybe Judith stays in the hilltop or something. I mean, who knows? Maybe she takes on that role of like Enid did the Sophia role.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, Jesse, what do you think, man?
You know, honestly, I'd say kill the kid, let the baby live. I'm gonna be the horrible person.
So you're saying kill Judith?
Kill Judith, she's old
enough. Let baby relive?
And then let baby relive.
Wow.
Judith ain't getting popped.
Rick thinks it's Shane's kid, so wouldn't have that much attachment to her.
I don't think
that. No, he does, though.
I think he adores that child.
Yeah, he does, yeah.
Nah. Nah.
Yeah, he loves it. It's still not 100% that it's fucking Rick's baby, all right?
Can we not go over this again? God, we had this whole argument one other time, and
we had it in a previous
the only glimpse of baby Ree was in the fucking table scene at the end of
We didn't even see Judith in that scene, did we? I don't remember.
Judith was running around playing with a fucking puppy, All right, we didn't see her. Baby Rhee,
they have puppies. They have puppies in the post-apocalypse.
Yeah, they had a fucking dog too. A male.
I don't think it would be very beneficial to have a dog in post-apocalypse.
Yeah.
All right.
God, I don't know, but that's a good question, man. That's interesting where they go. There's a lot of things they could do with that.
Where are the puppies?
All right. I think that's gonna do it for us. Yes. For this Q&A. We want to thank you guys so much for supplying us with these questions. We hope we've answered them. Again, if we didn't get to your question on camera, you know, we'll definitely try and get an answer to you in the comments. Yes. But again, we really appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much. We appreciate all the support, all the comments and everything that you guys, you know, give us. It's amazing. So we keep doing this because you guys engage with us and we love it, and that's why we still do it. So thank you very much.
Yeah, absolutely. These are my favorite friggin' videos. I love doing these Q&As.
Yeah, right.
And absolutely. We do these, especially since on all the social medias, with the little typing on the comment section in YouTube. Look for us on iTunes. Look for us on Instagram. Check us out on
Twitter.
Check us out. We enjoy it. We, you know, we love doing these kind of videos, and we just love answering all your guys' questions. So hit us up on the social medias. We'll always be there to say hello.
Yep. Guys, if you haven't been watching Badlands, get on it. I don't know what you're waiting for. Go binge the first season and then get caught up, and then go check out our videos because we love this show and we're all about it. We're all into it, you know?
Mm-hmm. And you know what? You know Comic Blitz is there. You know the code already. Don't forget about that. And we have a little bit of an announcement. Just a small one. Mm-mm. We're going to have a new series coming out this coming Thursday. That's right, I'm going to be spearheading it, and it's going to be a history of the houses of sorts for Game of Thrones.
Yes.
First house is Stark, so be sure to check in for that.
Definitely. Oh,
man. Very
get
cool.
On it.
Very cool.
Trying to bring you guys, and we're going to be streamlining our videos a little bit, and you'll be noticing that. But we're trying to get more content to you guys. You know, and even though our actual physical real-world time hasn't changed, we're still going to try and pump out more content to you. So that means we need to streamline some of our videos so we can get some more content out to you, grow the channel more. So if
we had 97 hours in a day, we could get out as many videos as we need.
That'd be great. that'd be so great. Hey, you know what? It's on the slate. That's what we're aiming for. So if you guys could tell anybody who watches TV and the stuff, if you're into anyone that's into the same stuff that we are, like you guys are, you know, let them know. Bring them on in. Make some popcorn and watch these videos, or whatever you want to do. Or if you listen to it, awesome, great. Tell someone else about it. That'd be so awesome. Thank you so much, guys. It's going to do it for our Walking Dead Q&A Season 7, Q&A number 3 video. Thank you so much, guys. We'll see you on the next Q&A.